All right, guys, here we are to talk about episode 5, season 8 of The Walking Dead.
Yo.
So we finally get to see what happened to Negan.
Thank fucking God. On the one hand, also, I don't know, on the other
hand. Like, while I'm glad to know what happened, it doesn't make any sense.
Did I spoil this for you, by the way?
Would you have spoiled this for me?
I said something like, we're going to see, so like, I remember I was like, based on the thumbnail, we're going to see some characters
that we haven't seen in a while. We were going to see Negan. I don't know if it was you that directly did that.
It could have been Michonne.
Could have been. I had a feeling it was going to be Negan.
It was about time. I think for the last 3 episodes we've said, maybe next episode we'll see what happened to fucking Negan.
So, like, let's just for a second talk about the world they live in. Great. And the fluctuating power levels of zombies, which is infuriating.
Yes.
For anyone.
Right.
So in an episode prior, we see a handful of zombies, maybe like 12, rip a tiger apart with their bare hands.
Yep.
This is an animal that is entirely made of muscle.
One of the most terrifying creatures on Earth.
They can drag, like, gazelles up to the fucking top of a tree. Like,
sure.
Crazy shit. And in this episode, they're just like, like,
quit it. Get away from me.
They walk through hundreds of zombies surrounding them. And, like, their plan originally was like, all right, like, you know, we'll coat ourselves in guts.
We'll do the guts
thing.
We'll
be fine. That quickly wore off for whatever reason. And now they're just in the thick of it with, like, an avalanche of zombies, like, even falling upon them at the end to make you believe, like, oh, he might be dead, like a Glenn Dumpster situation.
It's the cheapest, dumbest thing ever. I hate it so much.
And then he just walks in, like...
Which is like, oh, he's such a badass, but yeah,
no,
I don't
know. He's a badass, but there's a point where a baseball bat is not effective, and they're so close that you couldn't even get an appropriate swing.
All of his swings are these weird, like,
that's all you have. Swinging that's
thing.
All you have.
I know it is, but that's still, and he just does like the Japanese railroad push thing. They push him into the subway with a big stick.
What is that reference to?
Oh, the trains are so crowded in certain places, I think particularly in Japan, possibly other Asian places,
okay.
Where they have to get all the people onto, like, the thing. So they have, like, pushers, like dedicated people who, like, push them onto the thing.
Really?
And sometimes they use a big, soft, like stick.
All right.
Everybody on.
I just find that reference deep.
Oh.
Had to look it out, because mine would have been like, you know, like a hockey check, and you're like, you know, a Japanese railroad pusher.
I never played hockey.
you've seen it.
No.
All right. Moving on.
I thought that Wayne Gretzky was a pizza delivery boy. I have no idea.
Well, he was the fastest. He set records, you see. Type of thing where characters are acting ridiculous and just working appropriately.
And that's a good thing to mention first, right? Because, like, and they don't even really, so, like, if you wanted to, right, maybe you could be like, well, those tiger-killing zombies were mutants. They were by the toxic waste or something like that. If you really needed to or something like that. But even just in the same episode, right, like, zombies fell down the hill and then were, like, eating prisoners just because their hands were, like, bound.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know, based on seeing Gabe and Negan, you could just kind of kick them and then wait 10 minutes and then kick it again and then wait 10 minutes and kick it again.
No, it's ridiculous. Because when I was thinking, like, I always try to think, what would I do in this scenario?
Right.
And, like, never would that have been what I would do. I was, like, actually thinking, because, like, I try to think of things, like, really logically, like, well, what would I do? I'm like, well, I have a finite amount of time, but it's probably a good amount before they would actually break free of this. I would weigh the pros and cons of, like, if I was really quiet, would they eventually hear a noise and move away?
Yeah.
Or there's, like, the, well, how would I get out? Well, I have a gun that has a full clip. I have at least between 7 and, 12 bullets in that gun. And I have a baseball bat. What I would probably have done would be to shoot a couple of holes in the tin roof of the structure I'm in, and then just bash them until I could peel it like a fucking sardine can and just be on the roof. Because at least then, from a distance, my people, who I'm in a facility of, would see me or hear me or hear gunshots, like, someone's still alive. But instead, they're like, all right, we're going to fight our way through this. And did you notice how every shot that was taken with the gun was directly over Negan's ear? Like, I'm like, the man would never hear again.
Well, we can't talk about, there's literally a, like, YouTube famous with, you know, film theory thing about everyone on the show being deaf.
They have to be.
And that's why, but that's that's why the zombies are even, like, a threat. It's because everyone's deaf now. No, like, Agreed, but at that point, it's like the show doesn't even make sense in like the first place. People were saying like in episode one when Rick fires the gun inside of
The tank?
like the tank, he should have lost like 80% of his hearing or something like that or whatever.
And like not only that, like I've seen things where people fire a gun in too close a proximity to inside of a hall, and like they get like a concussion from it and they start
Oh
vomiting. Like
no, stuff's horrifying.
There's
in
a
general.
great episode of Doomsday Preppers where a guy makes like a bunker in like a tree or something, and the guy doesn't put his gun far enough out of the window to take a shot, and the noise like just knocks this guy on his ass. He's like, oh, and his equilibrium gets fucked, and he's vomiting. He's like, you fucked up, John. You fucked up, John. I might have to kick you out of the bunker. Oh God! Like it's this whole real thing, and he's like, oh, I didn't know.
Was it like a drill? Why were they
They
shooting?
do practice drills.
My God.
But like, didn't lean out far enough, so the shot was completely in the bunker.
That throws everything ever out of knowing how things work ruins everything,
Yeah,
basically.
mostly, yeah.
Because earlier when I was talking about the zombies, I didn't even say it, but I realized like those zombies fell down a hill. Shouldn't they just be like a they're just like a loose bag of bones and shit?
Yeah.
They should have just been like stains by the time they got to the
But
end.
like, here's the thing, and I was talking to somebody else about this, where we have the potential outcomes on how this situation could run, where eventually it could be all the zombies just degrade and there are no zombies ever again.
Right.
But the thing is, you can't really put a counter on that because you don't know how old every zombie is. So potentially all the ones that just rolled down the hill didn't turn into a balloon popping party of zombie guts because maybe they were just turned a week
Yeah,
prior,
like
a
the
month
newer
prior. Yeah,
zombies,
exactly.
yes.
So like not knowing that, and there will always be zombies as long as there are humans because of how it works. When you
Yeah.
die, you become a zombie. It's not
Like no
a
matter
bite
what.
scenario. So
Yeah.
yeah, there's always gonna be some fresh ones because
Yeah. And I try to judge them physically if I'm like that one looked really gnarly. Why is he able to do that or whatever? That one looks like
yeah.
this or whatever. But the science of zombies is always a mess.
It doesn't have to be because
Ooh.
you could make a lot of things. Like, okay, across the board, this is that. They're this fast. This wouldn't work. He would die. Okay, we have to think about a way to get out of this. Like, if we had a thing where it's like, no, you're fighting, 20, like, cause and Eugene does a thing where he's like, we could not have these
That'd be
people hold off
inadequate.
that thing. It would not work. After this much time, they would die. But then in that same thing, you have two guys fight off like an army. You're like,
Do the
I
opposite.
don't know if that's true, Eugene. I
I
think
don't
your
know,
math is
Eugene.
working off of what we want the world to be, but it's not always that way because it's not
Well,
convenient for the
I
plot.
was just gonna say Eugene's math never takes plot armor into account. He doesn't understand
Yeah.
how like two people. Because I, it's one thing when it's like Daryl or someone when it's like, well, they're such a badass, and that's the whole point of this. Is he such a
Yes.
badass that like, like Michonne just shows up. She's like, yeah, I walked. Well, what'd you do? Well, I had my sword, so I just killed like 1,000 zombies. Oh shit! Like it's this like crazy thing
Yeah.
or something like that. But
A good
so.
swordsman honestly would last a crazy long
Exactly.
time just
Yeah.
because of it's like, well, the zombies got in
And she
close,
had
but
like
you
the
fucking killed
and
them.
she had like the pets at a certain point and all
Yeah.
that stuff. Like a whole thing. We're like, okay, I am on board with this. But then for certain other for certain other characters, it's like, okay, well, you didn't show it to me, so that's fine. So maybe they figured something out, or they didn't bump into many zombies or whatever. But here, you're both showing me and then having it be a thing because like Negan's a badass, but he didn't do any like badass things. He
No,
did
like Negan
like
pulling a
normal things.
Tyrese with the hammer and like
Yeah.
killing everything, I'd be like, I'm like,
Right.
okay, yeah,
Like,
I could see
fuck.
him getting into a weird rage and just clubbing everything to death. But then
Right.
like the priest, he's got nothing. He's
He's
like a
shooting.
chump. He's shooting, but he only has so many shots.
No, and he's
And
like
like
wheeling around and he's already doing his whatever and stuff. And then, like, they somehow. And, like, they don't show how they eventually get away because it makes no sense for them to get away.
Yeah,
And that always
exactly.
bothers me with these fucking things where it's like, well. Like with the Glenn thing, we don't see how he got under the bin, right? Because he couldn't have gotten under the bin. It's insane.
Yeah.
Or like, why can't zombies just keep squeezing? Because they don't care that their stuff's getting like crushed or whatever, right?
Yeah.
Like it makes absolutely no sense. And like, why would they ever leave? The zombies here just never leave. Why did the zombies leave the bin or whatever? Because something scared them away or something like that. There's all sorts of fighting going on around where the Negan facility is. There's all sorts of things happening.
Yeah.
Ugh!
Speaking of all sorts of fighting,
Yeah.
we got Daryl and Rick fighting
I know.
and
So,
losing the powerful gun.
yeah, we pick up where they left off. They talk to the dude crawling, crawling along the side of the road. What was the point of that conversation? I couldn't hear some of the dialogue. He just
It
says that,
seemed like there
like,
was no point. Like, your
oh,
people are dead. My people are
they're
dead.
all dead.
They're all dead, except for the crazy bitch, the king, and that fat axe man.
Yeah, the fat guy with the axe, the king, and that some crazy short-haired lady. I was like, That's it. Yeah. There you go. Sweet.
And that's it.
And they kind of do the look like, oh, good, our friends are safe or whatever. Like, all right, cool.
Well, because of that group, who else do they even know the name of? Nobody.
No, exactly. So that, like, and I know. And that's what's
and
sad.
And that's almost exactly talking about plot armor, where it's like, yep, they're main characters. They're not going to die.
Who survived? Well, the people that we know survived.
Yeah.
That was full of fun. But they fight, right? We get another fight. So last episode, we had Jesus, or like two episodes ago, whatever, we had Jesus and Morgan fighting.
Yeah,
and
a lot of him fighting.
Daryl fighting and all that stuff. Do you think that this is contrived? That this is, does this work for you, right? We're setting things up. We're clearly setting things up.
Well, like, does it work for me? Yes. Is it a little dumb? Yes. Are they still friends? Clearly, because he's like, you know, headlocks are illegal.
That was
or
so
whatever.
Awesome. That saved it for me.
It did.
Because
like, I was like, okay,
Joe Cole's
still,
a legal asshole. And
it was
I'm
still
like
brotherly yep. fighting at that point.
Exactly. It's not like suddenly we're mortal enemies or whatever. But uh-huh. we have like a difference of like opinion, right? And there was a theme. There was actually a theme running through this at like the very least.
Yes.
Where I feel like if you're going to contrive things, at least do it for like a purpose, right? So we have Negan almost, it almost cuts from Negan saying like, well, you know, I didn't kill, you know, I killed those people, but I didn't get them killed. That was your boy Rick or whatever. And then later, Daryl, yeah. you know, Daryl says the same opposite thing, which is like, yeah, so what if they die? That's not on, you know, if like the workers die, that's on them. I'm just doing this or whatever. Like, it's this weird
and honestly,
abdication
they've gotten
of responsibility
fucked enough and lost enough family and friends yeah. and stuff over things where it's like, well, you should have killed that person. That, like, you'd think you'd become the cold, heartless person yeah. where it's like, no, I want to survive. You have to die well, because I don't know if you'll kill me.
And Daryl's the one person, almost the one. I haven't thought about anyone else enough. Don't always do that. Daryl's a person where that really works for me because, like, most recently he was eating dog food sandwiches, but even, you know, even, like, before that, right, he really regretted not killing Dwight, and he really
yes.
said that to, like, other characters. He talked about it with Carol, and it was, like, an argument between them,
but
right?
But did not...
And move forward, you know?
Like, his sentiment on this changed after that part where it was him and Carol, and he didn't kill...
Yeah.
That one boy, right?
Yeah, yeah. No, and there's, you know...
Like, he said to not kill that boy, too, right? He was the
yeah.
one Carol wanted to kill him, and he said not to kill him.
I don't know
so he just wants some food, And then, like, shortly after that, like, everything started going poorly for him, and he became the character that, like, that Carol has been all along.
Yeah, I guess they looped it around or something. In my head, I have a vague recollection of Daryl kind of breaking down and becoming more and more of, like, a, it's them or us.
Yeah.
Because, well, and they've been spoon-feeding it to us this season where he's shot several people, where, like, Rick's like,
yes.
damn, dude, like, he was surrendered, like, he was, like, whatever, like, he's just a dude. Like, fuck. And then Daryl's like,
but you
like,
can't
well,
live your life with, like, you know, one eye open.
I know.
You have to kill these people.
No, and, like, you know, so much of this season has been this one, like, military operation that I've just been like, this is not the time to debate things like that or whatever.
That's what's so crazy to me about all this, is they should have slaughtered all those saviors that they caught, because now that whole party is guarding these people.
Mm-hmm.
When your friends, you lost all the kingdom, and maybe you wouldn't have had those people... join the war.
Right? Yeah. No, and like at this point, anyone that you show mercy on can run directly back to your enemy and give them information
yeah.
or something like that. So like it's not a good time to have these struggles and these like debates.
No, not, there's no
you
room
can,
for it.
You could totally have these debates and all that stuff. And I feel like it's like waiting to happen with all those workers and all that business or whatever. And that's awesome. That's fine.
The workers, though,
the
you
middle,
can see are like
it's awesome.
Hanging on by a fucking thread.
I know. It's much more tense than you would have thought. We're getting this nice other side of it.
And now we
here,
find
right?
out, so, like, all their power is from generators, I guess.
Right.
At the Savior compound. I don't know what you want to call it. So that's interesting, too,
yeah.
where I'm like, how long and how much gas could you possibly be finding that could do these things? It doesn't seem practical.
Tremendous amount of resources, Stephen.
I Googled at one point, like, how long gasoline lasts.
Yeah.
And it does not last that long. Like, you can't just store it in gasoline
oh,
form
yeah, no.
for more than... What is it? It's like 10 years or something.
That's another issue with the show is how the gas would just run out. Like gas, pharmaceuticals, there are certain things that like you can't make more of even if you get like some peace and quiet and some time, right? You need to like...
Given enough time to scavenge, though, you could find a lot of this
you
stuff that can last you forever.
Yes, because there's very few
pharmaceutical-wise.
Yeah.
But the gas stuff, if you're not making new gas and gas goes bad, you're kind of screwed.
No,
there should
no,
be more
yeah.
bicycles.
There should be more bicycles, right? If you want to get realistic, right, you'd probably have to figure out a way to, like, ferment something and get methane or get some sort of gas or something or, like, commandeer a power, like a hydroelectric power plant or something.
Well, I would
probably
think...
have to get something
I would think,
to work.
Well, you know, potentially, I take it all back, actually, because you could have high proof alcohol and maybe in a generator, and
you
that
might
could
be
probably
able to
work
get
inefficiently,
some
but probably
ethanol
work.
and some other fuel sources. You'd have to come up with some way to like renewably create something to either
Yeah.
burn or make something like steam engines or something like that. You'd have to do all this like crazy stuff. Be interesting.
Yeah.
You have to. I found this book at the old library
Well,
about how to make a steam
that's why I'm
engine.
saying Alexandria is the place where I would probably make
Yeah.
my camp, because they have solar.
Oh yeah. There you go.
So
Exactly.
that's the only one. But eventually, solar panels, like, they only work so long.
A lot of stuff wears out, and that's the kind of thing is we don't have like the well we in the future of the like apocalypse, you can't really make new like microchips or like
No,
circuit
every
boards or
year that goes
stuff
by,
like that, right?
each generation is less equipped for an apocalypse.
Yeah, sure.
And that's just a
Each
fact.
day we stray further from the earth.
'Cause think a couple hundred years ago,
Yeah.
yeah, you could do that. And
Right.
now it'd be like, well, I have to what? Germinate? What the fuck is that?
Oh
Like,
yeah, no one knows how anything works. If
yeah.
I had to like grow crops, I would just like trial and error, and I would waste a lot of stuff, and I'd probably
Most
die.
definitely.
Oh yeah, that would suck.
It would be terrible.
Because right now I would just Google it, but even then, like even like the Google results would have shown you like, well yeah, first you go to Home Depot and buy all this stuff, and then I'd be like, well I'm fucked. I'm
Yeah.
immediately fucked, right? Even if I had somehow like
Presumably,
saved
though,
instructions.
a safe place
Yeah.
to loot. I don't know how much stuff, like,
Home
barring, like,
Depot?
yeah, barring wood and some salty tools, I think you'd,
Sure.
like,
No.
aside from fortifying, I think seeds might be pretty safe.
Oh, I need some seeds.
Yeah.
Trade my seeds.
Just survive on bird seed your whole life, because that's
Just
what was, like, those 80-pound
I'm
bags,
just
just
eating suet logs and all that stuff, disgusting things.
whatever you need, though. Survival,
Exactly.
survival.
Oh, yes.
All right, so what else happens in this episode?
Speaking of survival, I have no idea what I'm about to say, but I'm just going to say, speaking of survival. All right.
Segue.
To take a It would have worked for any topic in my notes. It's perfect. Just to like lay it all out there, right? We've been calling that there'll be something happening where Negan will be like redeemed or whatever,
Yes.
and we even kind of arrived, at the point once things happened the way they did in like the first episode. Well, I guess Gabe's like the right person to do that anyway. That kind of makes
Yeah, a
sense or whatever.
confession.
Yeah, and it fucking literally. And so it was so on the nose that it kept like bothering me, but I still was okay with it. So in like the like. In the beginning of the episode, we even have to show Gabe like praying for like I just want a purpose. I just want a fruitful
Yeah.
death and like a purpose. And I'm like, oh jeez. So he's gonna die with Negan helping him and his purpose. And then, but then later, and I wrote it in all caps because he says, maybe this is the reason. And I'm like, don't say maybe this is the reason. That's so dumb.
When they get back into the compound, where does he, doesn't he say, like, take my friend to room number two or whatever? I picture he's gonna be in, like, the fucking sunshine suite with the good champagne or whatever it's called.
He's gonna be, and he says gently, like twice
Yeah.
or whatever, to like emphasize, like this is not code for like kick him in the ass and throw him in there naked and feed him a dog food sandwich. I mean, literally escort him to like suite number two or whatever. No,
Yeah.
and like Eugene gives him this look, like oh no, it's happening to you now. It was an amazing facial performance, I thought.
No, I saw that and I didn't know
Yeah.
exactly how to read it.
I didn't know either, but that's what I mean. It's like you
Because I
had
don't
this
think
amazing,
the
like,
two of them even had a relationship.
not
Like,
they
they
weren't
were in the
tight, I don't
same
think.
rooms. No,
Yeah.
exactly. So I'm like, is he excited? Is he mad? Is he scared? Like, oh no, you're gonna
I
see through my whatever.
yeah, I took it like this, like dread of like something or whatever. And yeah, there's like a million ways to go with that, right? Does he have a plan of like undermining Negan and now it's like you're complicating everything. You're gonna like rat me out of my lies or you're gonna jeopardize my plan or maybe I'm
Yeah.
doing this and that and you'll be there and I have to save you too now when me and like Dwight leave to go off
Well, and
and live by ourselves.
I forget when he was first taken after the bullet fiasco. Did he say, "I'm a scientist, I'm a blah 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 this"?
Oh,
Like,
I think
is he
so.
scared because that guy could say he's not
Yeah.
really a
No,
scientist?
I think he lied about a bunch of stuff or whatever.
But at a certain point, it doesn't even
Which is
matter if he
fine.
lied. He's given you so much good advice
You would
that,
hope.
like,
And
I don't
Negan's.
think it even matters. You're a
Yeah.
scientist in the apocalypse. Like,
You're an apocalyptologist.
yeah.
No, I think he's proven himself by this point. I would hope, but a very nervous dude in general. So I'm really interested to see what's happening because we get all these other little him and Dwight talk for a minute. So that was a weird thing where like He says some stuff. Cause so okay, fuck.
It's
there's all these things
it's
going
given,
on. Yeah.
Is the South? Do you call pickles cucumbers? Because they look like they were pickled.
Cukes. Well, he then says pickle, pun intended. I think that they're on their way to becoming pickles.
Okay, they're not dead. They're brining still.
These are my choice cukes, and I think you can take it out and eat it whenever you want, and it's a matter of how far along into the process. I'm not a pickle head. I'm not into pickles or whatever. But yeah, they have this bonding thing over it. Because like when they first end up in the same room, I'm like, oh, they're in on it together. They both helped Rick or something like that. But everyone thinks Eugene helped Rick, but actually Dwight helped Rick.
Yep.
And this is a weird fucking thing going on where they are actually in on it, but they're not in on it or whatever. You know, I don't know what's going to happen there or something like that.
No, it's going to be interesting. There's a lot of cool stuff that can happen coming up. I don't know if it will because this show seems to have a trend of like ball dropping and not in a good way.
not the good type of ball dropping.
You know. Pun intended.
But
I don't know.
How many
episodes do you think we are till like a meltdown? I thought it was interesting they showed us that background of what that meeting was. I was in a meeting. He actually was in a meeting.
Interesting. So that whole thing was amazing. I really like getting more detail about how that organization like functions.
Yes, and we know that each person there, aside from Dwight and I think Eugene, is the head of an outpost.
Yeah, the one guy
said...
So
we know there are three outposts. We've seen, I think, three outposts get hit. So we do know that all the outposts, like, that is the extent of the outpost, potentially.
Yeah,
unless
because,
there are people that are like, oh, we meet on those ones on alternate Tuesdays. Like, if that's everybody, the whole organization is going down. And there's very little people still in that building because it seemed like it was only... The heads were what was left of the saviors.
Yes, because they were, and like the one guy who must by process of elimination be Gavin, the one other guy, who you know maybe they name you know call out his name at some point. He said like they hit us now when us three are like here and now we're severed from our groups and all that business and all that stuff. So yes, the kings were away at this conference and it was just whoever was left there and the. You know, stuff is spread or whatever the fuck. Like, it's very.
But I thought if Gavin, the one with the mustache, that you're talking about, right?
That's Simon.
Simon. Which one's Gavin?
The other guy.
The muter guy wasn't he the one that's in charge of the kingdom though?
The what kind of guy?
Better demeanor. He was the one like
the reasonable guy.
Yeah,
I think that's Gavin.
So he's as far as I've always taken it, the one that runs the kingdom.
He doesn't run the kingdom. He like deals with the kingdom.
Yes.
He has
oh yeah, you're right. That's not an outpost. Right. Yeah. Okay. All right.
Exactly.
I stand corrected.
His outpost must be closest to the kingdom or logically centered around it. But yeah, I kind of forgot that even was that guy because he's the guy who like tells the other dude like cut the shit, stop it. You're like stop escalating the situation. And the guy's like, what? I'm fucking with him. He's got a stick. I want that stick. Like all that bullshit. Right. He was that guy.
Yeah, that must be Gavin then. Yeah, correct.
By process of elimination, so he kind of lays it out and the conspiracy about how this was to happen and all that stuff. That was some good tension. I like getting the behind the scenes of like how does Negan treat these people? How does he do it? I don't know how I feel about this. I have to talk about this. So like I don't even know if I hate things anymore because I wanted to hate them and now it's my chance and it's fun to hate stuff. If I would have liked it if I hadn't hated earlier stuff or where I'm at, I'm all mixed up. I don't know what to do.
I think it's that most like my issue is that half of each of these episodes so far, and I don't mean like two and a half of them, I mean like half of each episode, like you know like 25 minutes or whatever, is like things where I'm like it didn't really get me anywhere.
Okay.
Like it all could have been summed up very quickly. There was no need to do that part. Like what is like?
Yeah.
Like we're not really getting towards a thing. It's as if you had like a show where like this show is six episodes, and they're like, we're gonna give you 10 now and milk it all the way along.
Yeah.
So it's the same information. Like this whole season probably could be done five episodes that were really good, but we're gonna get this like long drawn out
fucking
thing.
No, and I've like resented the filler for a long time, but I've also on this show here we like make predictions. We talk about stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, I think they'll do this. And, like, I think it's... I feel like it's been a year where I've been saying, like, is Negan redeemable? How are they going to do that? What are they going to do? Like, oh, like, what are you... Are you going to find out, like, Negan's really just been the good guy all along, and he's just been doing blah, 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 blah. And now they're, like, literally just, like... Because they're like, well, now you're going to see more about what happens with Negan when, like, other people aren't, like, around. And like, he's literally saying stuff like, if you kill the right person at the right time, you could save 100 and all that bullshit.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what the fuck? Because he clearly enjoys killing and fucking with people.
Yes.
He's clearly like,
But it's calculated.
But he was meant to be, or like presented as this like irredeemably bad guy, and now they're like undoing it by just like having just filling in these little details about his like philosophy must have been this all along. Does that really explain all
well,
of his
and
behavior?
As bad as and crazy yeah. as he is, and how you'd think nobody would like him at all. How happy was the fucking crew when he got
yeah,
back?
No, I know.
Oh, thank God, Negan's here, blah, blah, because he does rule in Iron Fist, but he does rule.
It's like some sort of weird cult or something, though, where they're like, thank God for you,
you got to think, though, in a world yeah. where outside is death.
Yeah.
Like, you need someone you can look up to, like, oh, God, they're scarier than death.
I'm not saying that it doesn't make sense. I'm not saying that I'm not on board with it. I'm uh-huh. just shocked at like how it's playing out or something like that. I'm not sure, again, how it could have been done better or something like that. But I feel like up until this episode, Negan was the boogie, like the boogeyman monster.
Yeah.
And now, all of a sudden, now it's like, yeah, I had a wife, and yeah, this and that. I just wanted it to feel better once this finally happened, I guess. I can't explain it, like, logically.
Yeah. I'm interested for the next episode, though. It's opened up some doors that I think could be good. Which outpost do you think that girl runs?
I don't know. I'm very unclear still about where things are, what is happening. That's my like one of my main things or whatever.
And the other girl who we've seen before with the face tattoo, she's still around.
Where is she? She's just gone?
Well, she came Barat up today.
Or whoever? Did she?
She was the one that said, like, no, we got a problem. No, it's the workers are coming up.
Oh, no. Said, the blonde girl, I know. Yeah, she was flirting with the guy from the kingdom
yeah,
or whatever.
Yeah.
She's great. She's fine. But there was another one who was going to Alexandria. I guess.
Oh,
they,
yes.
I guess they just, like, replaced her with this other chick now from the other season.
Her name
was Barat, I think, because it was a weird name or something close to that. And now she's just gone. There's just this other chick there.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on with that. I also am really not cool with the fact. So, like, this episode, maybe the episode before this were probably like the best ones. Like, things are getting better, right?
Yeah, things are happening.
It's good. But, they're just back inside. Like, everyone was outside on the catwalk. And, like, Gregory got, like, knocked off or, like, pieced out or whatever
yeah.
the fuck. And, like, all these scenes are happening as if there wasn't shooting at them and they just, like, went directly back in the door, but Negan didn't, and we still haven't seen that. It feels like a thing where, like, they didn't get coverage of a scene and they just had
yeah.
to, like, figure it out. Like, it's very weird to me, and I have a lot of trouble with shit like that on a show that feels like it's such
but
a big, important
thing. But it also shows us that we were originally like, oh, they must be at a satellite outpost. No, they are at the main thing. The workers are there.
I know, which is crazy, because we had to make up all this shit to make it make sense. Like, oh, they must have just scattered back to, like, the main thing. Or, like, Rick's like, or like, oh, they radioed, oh, they're coming from the thing back to here, from the thing, but I went there, and what the fuck is going
now,
on?
I don't know where, and they say, like, in the very beginning, like, should we go out with all the boys, a big show of force, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
So you think there's a lot of boys there.
Yeah, no, so now I'm back to that original
thing
they? From episode one. Was episode one just a really poorly filmed firefight? Because you had convinced me that, well, no, they were just making noise and breaking windows, right, to lure the zombies, and so the zombies
if
could get in.
If that was a poorly filmed firefight, that's so bad.
That's what I'm saying. So isn't that what it had to have been now, and we just have never shown it?
It couldn't have been, because how would they not have just won instantly, 3-floor height advantage, aiming into a circle? Like,
yeah.
It doesn't make any sense.
Well,
I can't allow that to be true.
Something happened, though, I feel like, in the production, because they even have Negan say, like, they got some weird armor or something, we'd just be wasting, you know, metal on metal. Let's go talk to him. Fuck it. Goes outside or whatever and everything, and then everything flows from there and all that shit.
God, horrible shit. Anything else happen this episode?
It doesn't make sense to me.
Swing me away from this horrible thought in my brain.
I'm good with that stuff. There was a little more I wanted to get out of something here.
I do think it's interesting how we spend this whole time trying to find that gun and don't just pull that gun out immediately before we start a fight amongst each other. I think that's such a waste, because that would have been your, like, penetrating power. You could have actually done some things with your life.
It was kind of contrived, right? It kind of felt like a... And, like, was that the only guns left? Are we done with those guns now? Is the whole thing over? Or are there more of those guns
That
somewhere?
Was probably the only big guns.
Because wasn't that going to be the whole thing, is, like, you've ratcheted it up by armoring your cars, but like, we have a fucking machine gun. We have a 90...
Like a 50 cal, like, or whatever.
Sorry, 90, yeah, 50 cal to, like, then counteract that, and it's this weird, right? Isn't that the flow of
yes.
things here? So that's just off the table.
Like, having it off the table is good for you, but owning it is way better.
Oh, no,
lost that.
But I'm saying, like, narratively, right? Are we just building to episode 8 and we're just going to forget about this? Because shouldn't the whole point of this be... Like everyone's forced, because like we want peace. We know we don't want to slaughter you. And we armored all of our cars, and we've organized all of our people, and we've done target practice for months, and now we can do all this shit, right? But we're just gonna set up and be like, we need to talk, right? You want to kill us all, so you have this gun that could just kill us all. So we need to find a way to lure you here and get
the gun
away. Did they
even know about that gun though until they were like killed by it essentially?
And that was the whole thing now. And like, but the people who got killed by the gun didn't have any of the armor. And now the guns are just gone before those two things even interact. It feels weird to me. I'm sorry.
Imagine how different the episode could have been if the first place they would have attacked had that gun. Ah, they've killed us all. We're all dead.
Right, right. And that could have been a whole thing where like now Daryl doesn't want to follow Rick because like one of his plans has failed again. And Daryl's like just like let's just go for the throat and kill them all. And Rick's like no, that's we didn't expect them to have this crazy gun. We just have to fix the gun problem, and then we can try again. And he's like, we're not going to try again. I'm going to go kill Negan in his sleep. Let's go. And he's fucking going and all that shit. Oh, God. I feel like there was more with the conversations of Gabe and Negan that should be addressed or something like that. I don't know. Do you remember? Did you care about that? Did you like that?
At the time, I liked it. It didn't leave any real lasting impression on me.
Yeah, I feel bad about that because there was a lot of stuff there.
Yeah, talk about his wife and how she died before all this stuff happened.
And he was like, I don't know. I felt that I've already like addressed it, I guess. But like his arguments for how things are and how they're actually not really that bad or something like that. All that stuff I thought was effective and worked and did its job. And that's what I've been expecting them to eventually do this whole time. Right. Like it's an economy. Some people win, some people lose, but no one's going hungry. And then, like the guy who was in charge before me, he wasn't leading shit. The minute this happened, that happened, it went through all this fucking bullshit, and you're like, okay, I guess I'm on Team Negan now. I'm on board. Honestly, with Jeffrey Dean Morgan's charisma and all that stuff, this whole time, I kind of knew that they couldn't just waste his character by being like unambiguously bad, and they had to pull some shit.
Of course.
But
when I think back though to like our original encounters with the Savior, when we had just like a roaming gang of like bikers essentially.
Yeah.
That doesn't even, like, really jive anymore with, like, well, what were they, like, doing? It doesn't seem like that makes sense.
Kind of not, right?
Right.
Because what is his goal, then, if he just wants to keep things under control? Like, fuck.
That whole, like, we have rules, we do this,
What?
The first people, like the dick biter people, the rocket launcher people, like...
I was just going to say, the guy that killed with the rocket launcher?
Those were all saviors, right?
Yeah.
So, like, their, like, whole credo of what they are... Then, unless there's that particular posse of them with the like, you keep what you want, you do this, blah blah, bring people into the fold. Like, it doesn't seem like that has carried on. And both are interesting in their strategies, but like, and they're both terrifying in different ways too.
Because what was their thing exactly? I'm not sure.
As I took it when we first met the Saviors, I thought it was just a group of killers that are takers.
Yeah.
Like, we don't farm, we steal. We don't blah blah with this.
Yeah, and we put our resources into the maintaining of this organization.
Yeah.
We grow our territory, and we strategically like they can give us pigs and they can give us sorghum, whatever the fuck, right? And strategically like under the guise of offering protection, right? Keep people in line and grow, and that's where, that's where we get our bread buttered and bread from, whatever the fuck.
That's an interesting tactic.
If you had done something, I don't even know what you could have done. I think that maybe they were in like a weird spot, like storyline wise, because you couldn't have made it like. Would that have been too shitty? I'll say the thing. So if Negan's trapped in there with Gabe and then kind of like reveals that it's all been like an act. And he's
this is
not the whole thing, right? Or something like that. Because, like this is clearly just Negan's personality, where he's clearly just decided, I'm going to be insulting and shitty and cruel, and this is fun for me, though. It's really, I'm a good guy, though. Like, it's this crazy thing to me. I don't know how this could be working. For like middle America or something like that. Well, Negan's got a point, you have to make Rick cut his kid's arm off because otherwise something worse might happen. Like, is that really, I don't know, right?
Well, it's something to be said for like you make somebody do exactly, like know their place and do exactly what they have to do because, life and death are on a razor's edge in this world.
The world is
and
shitty.
And people have to realize that.
I know that.
Listen to what I'm saying, or you're going to die, because you might get some of my friends killed.
But now the plan is we have to take the king, the widow, and Rick and kill them. and we have publicly to do that or whatever. Yes, to like send a message or whatever.
Well, because now they've killed like half his forces.
Yeah. So now the
potentially
plan has
their numbers are very like, skewed, because if you look at how many of them there were in the like when Glenn and Abraham died, there appeared to be like 100 strong in warriors, like or more.
In the shot of Negan giving the speech to his boys, which is at the same location where later Rick shows up, but there's no boys anymore. That's fucking crazy.
But that was like potentially that was a joint operation, and all the houses were together.
Yes.
And here we have them separated. I'm trying to think how many actually do I think died across the board here, because a good amount die in their sleep, and people die here, and things happen there. It's really hard to say.
Count them all up from all the different scenes of shooting. A lot of people have died, but they're still scared about more being on the way, and why would they go to the one place? Where you know, shouldn't they all be at the other place?
I don't know, guys. What do you guys think? Do you think that there's an appropriate amount of dead saviors? Does it seem like there should be a lot left? Do we think we're running the end of saviors?
Are you at all lost as to how many people are, where, and what, and whatever the fuck is happening?
Location-wise, it's a nightmare. You have to be at least a little confused. I think that's all we got for this episode here. Don't die in a fire, and we'll see you next time.